Good morning, students. Today's class, we are going to discuss our new topic, equations reducible to the linear form. You can take page number 34, and in that first we are going to discuss about the example problem, then exercise 2.6. You can refer the questions from your textbook, children. Okay? Today, we are going to continue exercise 2.6. Before going to continue the exercise 2.6, we can deal with our example problem. Actually, what is the topic we are going to discuss now? Equations reducible to the linear form. Okay, we are going to reduce the equation, which means they will give you an equation that will be somewhat, it will be very complex. What we are going to do is, we are going to reduce that equation to a simple linear equation. Linear equation means what? In that equation, if the variable contains a power 1, then that is a linear equation. So, this will be a very difficult equation, children. That equation we are going to reduce and we are going to make it very simple for our calculation. Okay, if it is difficult, can we able to do it easily? No. So, you can take page number 34. You can take example 18. Okay, what is the question given? Solve x plus 1 divided by 2x plus 3 equal to 3 by 8. Okay, see, this is also an equation, right? Because it has a equal to sign and a variable, constant, operations, everything. It is an equation. But what is the difficulty is, they have given that expression in numerator as well as in denominator. So, can we solve it directly? No. So, what we are going to do is, for this type of problem, we can do a cross multiplication. Cross multiplication na 8 into x plus 1 equal to 3 into 2x plus 3. Is it 8 into x plus 1 equal to 3 into 2x plus 3. Now actually this 8 is common for x as well as 1. 3 is common for 2x as well as 3. Right. Now 8 into x, 8x plus 8 into 1, 8 equal to 3 into 2x, 3 2s are 6x. 3 into 3, 9 plus 9. 8x plus 8, 6x plus 9. Okay, now it has become simple equation, right? Yes, because it don't have any brackets, it don't have any like numerator, denominator, like fraction form, nothing it is there. It is very simple. So, shall we bring all the variables towards one side and constant towards another side? Yes. 8x minus 6x, 6x go that side, it becomes minus 6x. 9 plus 8 go that side, it becomes minus 8. 8x minus 6x is 2x. 9 minus 8 is 1. Now I want only x, so shall I bring this 2 to that side? Yes, up x is equal to 1 by 2. X is equal to what? 1 by 2 is the solution. X is equal to 1 by 2 is the solution. Okay. We can check this also, whether we are getting LHS equal to RHS or not. Okay. If it is equal only, no, that is a solution. Yes. So, shall we take LHS first? X plus 1 divided by 2x plus 3. Is it? Yes. X plus 1 divided by 2x plus 3. Now, x value is 1 by 2 plus 1 divided by 2 into 1 by 2 plus 3. Is it? X value is what? 1 by 2 plus 1 divided by 2 into x value is 1 by 2 plus 3. Now, 1 by 2 plus 2 is, you can take LCM. 1 plus 2 divided by 2. Is it? LCM da 2 ku 1 ku LCM is 2. So into 2 into 2. So 1 plus 2 divided whole divided by 2. Now this 2 get cancel. 1 plus 3. So 1 plus 3. 1 plus 2. 3 by 2 whole divided by 4. Is it? So now 3/2 into 4 because both are in denominator. So you can multiply like this. 3/2, actually 3, 2 is in denominator. Actually this 4 is a denominator value. So 2 into 4 you can do. 3 divided by 4, 2s are 8. So what is the LHS value now? 3/8. RHS value is what? 3/8. Okay, LHS value is also 3/8, RHS value is also 3/8. Hence, x is equal to 1/2 is the solution of this equation. Understood? Next is your example number 19. Actually, this is somewhat like a word problem. Okay, what is the question? You can refer the question in your textbook, children. Present ages of Anu and Raj are in the ratio 4:5. Okay, what they have given? Present ages of Anu and Raj are in the ratio. They have given in ratio 4:5. So what will be the Anu's age? 4x. What will be the Raj's age? 5x. Is it like that? No, you will write it usually. Yes. 8 years from now, the ratio of their ages will be 5:6. So 8 years from now, so both will get 8 years more, right? Eight ages they will get more. So that time their ages will be in the ratio 5:6. Find their present ages. Okay, what we have to do? We have to find the present ages. So actually, what is the present age of Anu? 4x, is it? Next, present age of Raj is how much? 5x, because Raj 5x, because 4:5 given, children. So Anu's age is 4x, Raj's age is 5x. Now 8 years, okay, 8 years after, how much the Anu's age will be there? After 8 years, Anu's age will be 4x plus 8. This is my present age. After 8 years, I will be 4x plus 8. Next, Raj's age after 8 years will be 5x plus 8. Actually, this age ratio will be equal to 5:6. That is what they have given. 8 years from now, the ratio of their ages, how you will write the ratio? If 5:6, now how you will write? 5/6. 2:3, now how you will write? 2/3. Is it? So ratio of their ages after 8 years from now, the ratio of their ages, what is the ratio of the ages? 4x plus 8 is to 5x plus 8 equal to 5:6. Is it? What they are saying? 8 years from now. About 8 years from now, the ratio of their ages, will be equal to 5:6. Understood? This is actually the ages after 8 years. That ratio is equal to 5:6. Actually, how can you write this ratio? 4x plus 8 divided by 5x plus 8. Equal to 5/6. Can we write like this? Yes, because ratio A is to B. How you will write? A by B. Is it? So 4x plus 8 divided by 5x plus 8. Now this has become like last problem, right? This equation is somewhat critical. It's critical in the sense it is somewhat difficult for us to solve it. So shall we do the cross multiplication? Yes. 6 into 4x plus 8 equal to 5 into 5x plus 8. Is it correct? 6 into 4x plus 8 equal to 5 into 5x plus 8. Now, 6 into 4x plus 6 into 8, because 6 is common for both. Likewise, 5 is common for both. 6 into 4x, 6 4s are 24x plus 6 8s are 48. Is it? 6 4s are 24x plus 6 8s are 48 equal to 5 5s are 25x plus 5 8s are 40. Is it? Now is it correct? Yes. Now shall we bring all the variables towards one side and constant towards one side? 24x minus 25x. Is it correct? Yes. 40 minus 48. Is it correct? 24x minus 25x is minus x. 40 minus 48 is minus 8. Now, can we cancel both the minuses on both sides? Yes. X is equal to 8. So, what is the x value now? 8. So, actually what they have asked to find? Find their percentages. What is Anu's percentage? 4x actually. Appa 4 into 8. 8 for the 32 years. So, Anu is how many years old? 32 years old. Next. Raj's percentage. What is percentage? 5x. Appa 5 into 8. 40 years. So, what is Raj's percentage? 40 years. So, Anu's percentage is 32 years. And Raj's percentage is 40 years. Understood? Comes our exercise 2.6. You can take page number 35, children. You can refer the questions from your textbook. Solve the following equation. They said just to solve the equation, that's all. So here, what is the first question? 8x minus 3 divided by 3x equal to 2. Whether it is easily solvable? Yeah, somewhat we have to do some reduction process so that you can able to solve it easily. So, I am going to write this fraction as, is it correct? Why I am doing like this now? Actually, if it is a fraction in the left hand side and if it is a whole number in the right hand side, I can make this whole number to a fraction and we can do the cross multiplication easily. For my easy convenience, I have done like that. Okay, you can solve directly also. You can bring this 3x to that side, no problem. Any process you can do it, but the thing is, you should follow the rules. Okay. 8x minus 3 divided by 3x equal to 2 by 1 because I have converted this 2 as 2 by 1. Now, shall we do the cross multiplication? Yes. 1 into 8x minus 3, 1 into 8x minus 3 equal to 2 into 3x. Is it correct? 1 into 8x minus 3 equal to 2 into 3x. Now, 1 into 8x minus 3 is 8x minus 3, is it? 1 into anything is that same number. 2 into 3x, 6x. Now, shall we bring all the variables towards one side and constant towards another side? Yes. 8x minus 6x equal to minus 3, go that side, it becomes plus 3. 8x minus 6x is 2x equal to 3. I just want only x, so I am bringing this 2 to that side. Multiplication will become division. Up x is equal to 3 divided by 2. So, what is the solution? 3 by 2 is the solution of this equation. Understood? Actually, this is very easy problem, children. Okay. Next is your second problem. Okay. Now, actually, what is the second problem? 9x divided by 7 minus 6x. Is it? 9x divided by 7 minus 6x equal to 15. Actually, this is also a fraction and it is a whole number. What you will do now? 9x divided by 7 minus 6x equal to 15 divided by 1. Is it correct? Yes. Now, shall we do the cross multiplication? Okay. 1 into 9x equal to 1 into 9x equal to 15 into 7 minus 6x. Is it correct? 1 into 9x is 9x. 15 sevens are 105 minus 15 6 are 6 5s are 30, 90. 90x minus 90x because 15 into minus 6x is minus 90x. Shall we bring all the variables towards one side? Constant, only one constant is there, so let it be there. 9x plus 90x equal to 105. Minus 90x, go that side, it becomes plus 90x. 9 plus 90x is 99x equal to 105. shall we bring this x towards another side? X alone I want shall bring this 99 towards another side. X is equal to 105 divided by 99. Shall we able to cancel this in third table? Because 1 plus 0 is 1, 1 plus 5 6, it is a multiple of 3. 9 plus 9 18, it is also a multiple of 3. We can cancel this. 3 3s are 9, remainder 1, it becomes 15. 5 3s are 15. Now 3 33. Is there anything able to cancel this? No. So what is x value is equal to 35 by 33. I'll write near to that. Okay, x is equal to 35 by 33 is the solution of this equation. Is the solution understood? 35 by 33 is your solution of this equation. Understood, children? It is very easy. Okay, comes your third problem. Okay, what is the third problem? Z by Z plus 15 equal to 4 by 9. Actually, this problem and your example problem is somewhat similar. Yes? So, shall we solve this? Okay, what we will do first? We are going to do the cross multiplication. Is it? Because both the sides are fractions. Cross multiply it. 9 into Z equal to 4 into Z plus 15. Is it? 9 into Z equal to 4 into Z plus 15. 9 into Z is 9 Z. 4 into Z plus 4 into 15. 4 into Z is 4 Z plus, is it 9 into Z? 9 Z I will write. 4 into Z I will write 4 Z plus 15 into 4. 5 4 Z 20. 60. Plus 60. Okay, now shall we bring this variables all one side? 9z minus 4z is equal to 60. Is it correct? Yes, 9z minus 4x, 4z is 5z. 9 minus 4 is 5 equal to 60. Z is equal to 60 divided by 5. 12 5s are 60. Z is equal to 12 is the solution of this equation. It is very very easy problem. You can do verification also in the pencil in the side rough column. Okay, once you verify it, it is correct, then the solution is obviously correct. Okay, my dears, next is your fourth problem. What is your fourth problem? This is also a fraction equal to another fraction. So what we'll do, we can directly do the cross multiplication. Okay, so 3y plus 4 divided by 2 minus 6y equal to minus 2 by 5. Is it? 3y plus 4 divided by 2 minus 6y equal to minus 2 by 5. Shall we do the cross multiplication? Yes. 5 into 3y plus 4 equal to minus 2 into 2 minus 6y. 5 into 3y plus 4 equal to minus 2. Don't forget, children, it is minus 2. Into 2 minus 6y. Now, 5 is common for both. 5 3s are 15y plus 5 4s are 20. Minus 2 into 2, minus 4. Minus 2 into minus 6 plus 12y. Okay, minus 2 into 2 is minus 4. Minus into minus plus 2 into 6, 12y. Now, shall we bring all the variables towards one side and constant towards another side? Yes, 15y minus 12y. Because 12y go that side, minus 12y. Minus 4 plus 20 go that side, minus 20. Okay, 15 minus 12 is 3y. Is it? Minus 4 minus 20 is minus 24. Y equal to minus 24 divided by 3, because I am bringing this 3 to this side. 3 1s are 3, 3 8s are 24. So what is the y value now? Y is equal to minus 8. Don't forget this minus. Y is equal to minus 8 is the solution of this equation. Understood? Next is your fifth question. 7y plus 4 divided by y plus 3 equal to minus 4 by 3. As usual, like last problem. Shall we start solving it? You can also tell me when whatever I am saying also, okay? Whatever I am saying, just continue and say me, okay? Now, shall we cross multiply it? Yes. 3 into 7y plus 4. 3 into 7y plus 4 equal to minus 4 into y plus 2. Why I am just stressing in this means minus 4. Don't forget this. Minus 4 into y plus 2. 3 is common for both. Minus 4 is common for both. 3 7s are 21y plus 4 3s are 12. Because only plus, so I am putting plus. Minus 4 into y, minus 4y. Minus into minus, minus into plus, minus. 4 into 2, 8. Minus 4 into y is minus 4y. Minus 4 into plus 2 is minus 8. Now, shall we bring this all variables and constants? We can shift like this, right? 21y plus 4y equal to minus 8 minus 12. Is it? 21y minus y, 4y becomes this, comes this side, plus 4y, 12 goes that side, it becomes minus 12. 21 plus 4, 25y equal to minus 8 minus 12, minus 20. Y is equal to minus 20 divided by 25. 4 times 5 times in 5th table. So what is our answer? Y is equal to minus 4 by 5 is the solution. Don't forget to put this minus. Y is equal to minus 4 by 5 is the solution. Okay, children. Next problem is your 6th problem. What is the 6th problem? The ages of Hari and Harry are in the ratio 5 is to 7. Okay, they have given the ages of Hari and Harry in the ratio 5 is to 7. So, what is the Hari's age? 5x. Harry's age? 7x. Okay, 4 years from now, the ratio of their ages will be 3 is to 4. Like example problem, same as like example problem we are going to do. Okay, find their present ages. What we have to find? We are going to find their present ages. So, shall we write this? I am going to write the solution. Present age of Hari is how much? Present age of Hari is how much? 5x. Is it? Present age of Hari is how much? 5x. Present age of Harry 7x, is it? Do you have any doubt in this? Next, 4 years from now, so after 4 years, is it? After 4 years, Harry's age will be, Harry's age is equal to 5x plus 4. Is it? Because after 4 years, Hari's age is equal to 5x plus 4. Then, Hari's age is equal to 7x plus 4. So, actually what they are saying is, ratio of their ages, which is equal to 3 is to 4. Okay, shall we write that equation now? Yes. Ratio of the ages after 4 years is equal to the ratio 3 is to 4. Ratio of the ages, actually ratio of the ages after 4 years, okay? After 4 years is equal to the ratio 3 is to 4. So, what is our ratio will be? 5x plus 4 divided by 7x plus 4 equal to 3 is to 4. Is it? So, how we will write this ratio? 5x plus 4 is to 7x plus 4 equal to 3 is to 4. This is what the actually you should write in terms of ratio, right? Ratio of the ages after 4 years equal to 3 is to 4. But this can be written like this. Now, shall we cross multiply it? 4 into 5x plus 4 equal to 3 into 7x plus 4. 4 is common for 5x as well as 4. 3 is common for 7x as well as 4. 5 4s are 20x plus 4 4s are 16. 3 7s are 21x plus 4 3s are 12. Now, I am bringing all the variables towards one side and constant towards one side. 20x minus 21x equal to 12 minus 16. 21x go that side becomes minus 21x plus 16 go that side it becomes minus 16. 21x minus 20x minus 21x is what? 1x equal to 12 minus 16 is minus 1x da? Because greater number is minus 21, right? Appa 20 minus 21 is minus 1x. 12 minus 16 is minus 4. Minus minus get cancelled. Up x is equal to 4. Okay. What actually we have to find? We have to find the Hari's percentage. What is Hari's percentage actually? 5x. Up 5 into 4 is 20 years. Don't forget to put the years. Then it is wrong. Okay. Hari's percentage. What is Hari's percentage? 7x. 7 into 4 is 28 years. So now we have find the percentage of Hari as well as Hari. The example problem and this problem is same. Okay, children. Next, we are going to discuss our seventh problem. What is the seventh problem? The denominator of a rational number is greater than its numerator by 8. Okay, how that rational number will look like? It will be in P by Q format where Q is not equal to 0. You know, right? So, it will have a numerator as well as denominator. What they are saying na, denominator of a rational number is greater than the numerator by 8. Apo, if the numerator is x means denominator will be x plus 8. Is it? Because denominator is greater than the numerator by 8. Okay, next. If the numerator is increased by 17, apo numerator is increased by 17, they are saying, and the denominator is decreased by 1. Denominator is decreased by 1. The number obtained, if I do addition in the numerator and subtraction in the denominator, I will get a number as 3 by 2. So, what is that particular rational number? Okay, while I'll writing the solution, you will get a clear idea. Okay, children, don't worry. Okay, how that rational number will look like? First, what is the condition given? The denominator of a rational number is greater than its numerator by 8. Okay, the denominator of a rational number is greater than its numerator by 8. Let the rational number be x divided by x plus 8. Okay, because I told you in this rational number, denominator is greater than the numerator, right? If it is x means this is x plus 8. So, denominator is greater when compared to the numerator. Okay, then if the numerator is increased by 17, apo numerator increased by 17 means how you will write x is a numerator value increased by 17 na x plus 17. Okay, next denominator is decreased by 1. So what is actually our denominator? X plus 8 minus 1. X plus 8 is our denominator minus 1 because it is decreased by 1. So actually now our numerator will become x plus 17, denominator will become x plus 8 minus 1. So after this solving, what number you will get? 3 by 2. So now shall we write that new number? I'm going to write that new number x plus 17 divided by x plus 8 minus 1 equal to 3 by 2. Is it? Because numerator is added by 17, denominator is subtracted by 17. So after solving, I will get a rational number 3 by 2. So what we should find actual rational number is what? What is that actual rational number? We are going to find it. Okay, now x plus 17 divided by x, 8 minus 1 is 7. X plus 7 equal to 3 by 2. Is it looks like a somewhat difficult equation? Yes. So shall we solve this? 2 into x plus 17 equal to 3 into x plus 7. 2 is common for both, 3 is common for both. 2 into x, 2x plus 17 into 2. 7 2s are 14, 34. 34 equal to 3 into x, 3x plus 7 3s are 21. I am going to bring this 3x to towards that side and 34 to that side. 2x minus 3x is equal to 21 minus 34. 2x minus 3x is minus x. 34 minus 21 I am going to do 3, 1, 13. Minus 13. Okay, what is the actual value? 21 minus 34 na minus 13. Minus minus get cancelled up, x is equal to 13. So we got the value of x. So actually what is our rational number? Because we are going to find the rational number, right? Rational number is x divided by x plus 8. Our what is x value? 13 divided by 13 plus 8. 13 plus 8 is what? 13 divided by 21. So what is actual our rational number is 13 by 21. If I add numerator in 17 and denominator by minus 1, after solving you will get 3 by 2. So what is our rational number is 13 by 21. Understood, children? Today's class we have discussed about exercise 2.6. Actually, this is our last exercise in this chapter. So in this chapter, fully we have learned what is meant by equations and how to solve the equation to find the solutions. And there are many ways to solve the equation. Okay, not only balancing method, not only balancing method, we can use transposing method also, and we can find the solution for this problem. Once you find the solution, check whether that solution is correct or not. Okay, by using a verification. Once if it is verified it is correct, then it is the solution of that equation. Okay, children, I hope you all understood. Thank you.